नमस्कार, दिस इज शृंगिता बंदोपाध्याय. वेलकम टू माय सेशन ऑफ वोकल पैनोरमा. टुडे लेट्स एक्वेंट आवर सेल्व्स विद द इंडियन सॉल्फेज सा रे गा मा पा धा नी एंड कंपेयर द सेम विद द डो रे मी फा सो ला टी. इन माय टुडे सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू इंट्रोस्पेक्ट द एंटायर ऑक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर of Indian classical music, especially North Indian classical music. The name of Sa is Sharaj. The name of Re is Rishav. The name of Ga is Gandhar. The name of Ma is Madhyam. The name of Pa is Pancham. The name of Dha is Dhaivat. The name of Ni is Nishad. So thus we see that the solfeges are the abbreviated sounds of their original names. In Indian terminology, the octave is called saptak and the major scale is called suddha saptak. The reason is, in major scale, the notes that are used are pure chromatic notes, and these pure notes are called shuddha swara. And the octave or a saptak consisting of all the suddha swara are called suddha saptak. Now the question is, why a swara is called suddha or a saptak is called suddha? In a saptak or in an octave, we have 12 notes, of which 7 are derived universally pure notes. These notes are regarded as the pure notes in all the disciplines of music, like sa re ga ma pa dha ni, do re mi fa so la si. If we consider the si as the sa, it's going to be C D E F G A B. So these are suddha swara. There are 5 other notes in an octave which are in relation with the pure notes, either flat or sharp. This in Indian terminology called vikrita swara. So let us see which are the suddha swara and which are the vikrita swara. Since Indian music is primarily melodic music, the sa, the tonic, is very much important. All the other notes are in relationship with the sa. So first we fix the sa, then re ga ma pa dha ni is ascertained. Sa and pa is never changed, since sa is the mother, the plinth of the octave. It is unchanged, it remains unaltered, and so is pa. Pa is the anchor of sa. Pa is exactly the midpoint of the frequency distribution of the octave. If we consider sa as the first frequency and ni is the last frequency of an octave, pa is just the midpoint. So in Indian system, pa remains unchanged, unaltered. So there is no sharp and flat version of sa and pa in Indian music.
Sa re, sa.
सारे सारे गा सारे गा सारे गा मा सारे गा मा सारे गा मा पा सारे सारे गामा पाधा सारे गामा पाधानी सारे गामा पाधानी सो दीज आर द प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द नोट्स इन एन ऑक्टेव वी हैव फाउंड द कोमल रे इज सिचुएटेड बिटवीन Sa and Shudhre. The Komal Ga is situated between Shudhre and Shudhga. The Tivra Madhyam or the Tivrama is situated between Shudhma and Pa. Komal Dha is situated between Pa and Shudhdha. And Komal Ni is situated between Shudhdha and Shudhni. I repeat once again.
Sare. Sa re ga sa re ga sa re ga ma sa re ga ma sa re ga ma pa sa re ga ma pa dha sa re Sare gama padhani Sare gama padhani Sare gama padhani sa
Now from the descending manner
Sani Sani
Let me sing the Vikrita Swara or the Swaras that are flat or komal or sharp or tivras together.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa.
Now the Shuddha Swara.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa
Again the vikrita swaras
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa
In the descending manner
Sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa
This was the shuddha swaras and the vikrita swaras would be
Sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa.
Now I would sing all the swaras, the 12 notes of the octaves together in an ascending manner and in the descending manner both.
Sa re re ga ga ma ma pa da da re re sa.
So this is the concept of an Indian octave, a set of 12 notes. So considering sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni as a shuddha swara, the pure note, let us see how we can distribute the five other notes, the vikrita swara. The note between sa and shuddha re is called komal re, the flat version of the shuddha re. The note between shuddha re and shuddha ga is komal gandhar. Komal ga is a flat version of shuddha ga. The note between pa and shuddha dha is komal dha, the flat version of shuddha dha. The note between shuddha dha and shuddha ni is komal ni, the flat version of shuddha ni. There is one exception, which is the note between ma and pa, shuddha ma and pa. That is the tivra ma, that is the sharp version of ma. Thus we see that there is only one sharp version in Indian classical music, that is only on ma, tivra ma, the sharp ma. But the versions of re, ga, dha, ni are all komal, the flat. The difference between Western music and Indian music is, in Western music, the sharp and the flat, both versions are considered. Like you can say C flat or C sharp or a natural C. But in Indian music, you can only have shuddha re and komal re, shuddha ga and komal ga, shuddha dha and komal dha, shuddha ni and komal ni. We don't say tivar ni as another version of ni. The shuddha ni is sometimes said tivar ni. The shuddha dha itself is sometimes considered as tivar dha. The shuddha ga is sometimes considered as tivar ga. And shuddha re is considered sometimes as tivar re. So we can have the Indian octave or saptak in two different versions. The first one is sa, komal re, shuddha re, komal ga, shuddha ga, shuddha ma, tivra ma, pa, komal dha, shuddha dha, komal ni, shuddha ni. The second version is sa, komal re, tivra re, komal ga, tivra ga, komal ma, tivra ma, pa, komal dha, tivra dha, komal ni, tivra ni. I hope I could make you understand the entire notation system of Indian classical music. If you like this video, please do like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thank you very much and namaskar again.